Hi guys, welcome back to my channel. As I told you last week, today we try to do a little summary of the things we already learned and, to be more specific, of the three cases, nominative, dative, and accusative. So let's start. As you can see, we leave the second case out, which is genitive. This will follow very soon. As you can see in this little table, we have some good news and some bad news. The good news are that no matter what case you have, you can always find out which case it is by those so-called Fragewörter, question words. So, first case is nominative. The question words, as we saw in the table, and we see it here also, is wer oder was, who or what. So the nominative case is the basic form of the noun, and it is also the one that you find in the dictionary. This means when you learn a word, you normally always learn it in nominative, if it is a noun, of course. So, when your teacher asks you to always learn the article with a noun, it is the article in nominative. Das Haus, der Schüler, der Mann, die Frau, and so on. The nominative case is used for a subject of a sentence, and in a simple term, it is the person, the animal, or the thing doing the action in the sentence. So we have some examples here, and the nominative is bold printed. Dieser Schüler geht gerne zur Schule. This student likes to go to school. So if for some reason we wouldn't see this part here, we would ask who does go to school or who likes to go to school. So it is wer geht gerne zur Schule? And then we see immediately the answer, dieser Schüler, that student. So by asking the question, we see immediately what case we are talking about. We cannot say, for example, wer dieser Schüler geht gerne? This is completely wrong. So we cannot ask for the location for the school with wer oder was. It really only applies to the nominative. And this is why it is so helpful for you to know that. So der Schüler is the person that does the action, which is going to school. And this is the nominative. Next one is der Dativ. The question word for the Dativ is wem. It's like who for or who. If you see the little table I gave you before, it has wem oder was. Do you remember in the beginning of the lesson I told you we have good news and bad news? The good news are that we have question words that help us to find the right case. But the problem is, or the bad news if you want, if the thing is not a person, the question word what is the same everywhere. You only see the difference in the question word for a person. Wer, wem, wen. So it's super obvious when you talk about a person, but when you talk about a thing, the question word, unfortunately, is the same. At least we have those question words for persons that help us in the beginning. So back to dativ. The dativ case is used to show the indirect object of a verb. An indirect object answers the question who to or who for to what or for what. He gave the man the book. The nominative we talked before is definitely the he, the er, the person who does the action. But of course, we have here two objects. And we see immediately to who does he give the book or who did he give the book to? Of course, to the man, dem Mann. So we can see it quite clear, as I told you, if there is a person, we can ask with wem, who, to the man. And just so you know, the other object is accusative, but about this we will talk in a second. The dative case is used also after certain verbs or after certain prepositions, which always or mostly always take the dative. It depends. And we have a little example on the left side. Die Frau gab dem Gast das Ticket. For some reason, you don't know this part here. Of course, as an exercise to find out what case it is, you have to say, wem gab die Frau das Ticket? To whom did the woman give the ticket? And then you know immediately this is dative, because the answer is dem Fahrgast. So, you know, this one must be dative because it refers to a person receiving something. And here we have the person who does the action, which is the nominative. The last one for today is the accusative, the fourth case. The accusative has the question word wen oder was. The accusative case is used to show the direct object of a verb. This is also a person, animal, or thing affected by the action of the verb. And it's also used after certain prepositions, for example, in English, as, at, for, with, into, or from, just examples, which are always used or mostly always used with accusative. So now you're thinking, what's the difference between accusative and dative? Because in English, wen is also like who, but it is not who to. This is not the correct way, so it's easier to remember that this one is more direct. It's really a person or a thing or an animal that receives an affection or an impact. As for dative, it is an indirect object that answers to the question, who is it for? Who goes it to? I can only recommend you A, to not panic, and B, to learn it always by heart when you learn a new pattern or a new vocabulary. For example, during your studies, you learn the verb helfen. Okay, to help. The best thing you can do is not to learn it just like that. You have to check out your dictionaries, and most of the times there is information how to use it. Jemandem helfen, to help somebody. And you see immediately, because of the M here, this is dative, to help somebody. And we can say he helps the father. Er hilft dem Vater or dem Nachbar, the neighbor, anything. If you learn it immediately from the beginning correct, it will be so much easier because you have to learn it. There's no other way. The example here with the accusative is, er half ihm, den Hund in das Auto zu tragen. And now you think, it's helping. So what is what here? Well, if we go to the question, er half ihm, wen oder was in das Auto zu tragen? Right answer, den Hund, the dog. He helped him to carry the dog to the car. So the dog is the direct object, so the thing that is affected of the action, and the him is the dative object. And of course, the easiest one, the he part, is the person doing it. So if you wouldn't know, for example, this part here, now you should know how to ask for it. Wem half er den Hund ins Auto zu tragen? Wem oder was? It's to whom for. So whom did he help for? It sounds stupid in English, but it is like it is. Whom did he help for carrying the dog into the car? So who received this help? He did. Ihm. This is the main introduction to the three cases. I know it's confusing. I know it might be a little too much. You can watch my other videos. You can watch a lot of open sources, and you have to practice by yourself. And then it will be okay. So, I repeat. Erster Fall, Nominativ. Wer oder was? Here we have it with the underline. Der Ritter reitet zum Schloss. The knight. Reiten is going by horse. So let's just say to go. A horse rides. To the castle. Der Ritter is the person doing the action in the sentence. He is the big topic, not the castle. Dritter Fall, Dativ. Wem oder was? To whom for or what? Der König gibt dem Ritter ein Schwert. Now you can see the sentence is even longer. Der König, the king, gives a blade to the knight. To the knight is the object in Dativ. To whom is he giving the blade? To the knight. So the nominative became the king. Before it was the knight, but now it is the king. Last one. Vierter Fall. Akkusativ. Wen oder was? Who or what? Die Königin küsst den Ritter. The queen kisses the knight. Die Königin, person of action, became the subject in nominative. And who or what is she kissing? She kisses the knight. So the verb to kiss somebody requires accusative. And the verb to give something to somebody requires dative. A little exercise if you want. Please try to find the cases in those sentences. Okay, let's check it out together. Draußen steht die Straße unter Wasser. Outside, the street stands underwater. Or in English, we would say is underwater or is flooded, I think. What is the best way to ask? Of course, it is nominativ because we ask, was steht unter Wasser? What is underwater? We cannot say wen or wem. It's not correct. This is the topic of the sentence. It is nominative. Next one. Er hat schon wieder eine 5 in Mathe. The nominative part is here. He is the subject of the sentence in nominative. Wer hat eine 5? Who has a 5? Right answer, er. Now we have eine 5, a 5, which is accusative. Was hat er? And here is now the problem I told you before. Because it is not a person, it is a thing. So the what, the question word, which we said before, it's so helpful and so great, is the same as here. You have to deal with it. I'm so sorry. But luckily, we know that if we have here already a nominative, a subject, it's super rare that we have a second nominative in a sentence. I will talk about it another time. But most likely, we have here a dative or accusative object. So, eine 5 is accusative. Next one. Normalerweise liegen die Bücher auf dem Tisch. Wer or was liegt auf dem Tisch? Who or what lies on the table? The books. The books are our nominative. So the topic are the books. They do something. They are the actor in this sentence. And now we have the question here. Auf wem oder was liegen die Bücher? On whom or what are the books lying? And of course, a table is not a person. So the right one is auf was. Auf was liegen die Bücher? Auf dem Tisch. On the table. The preposition auf needs Dativ. If we say, die Bücher für den Unterricht liegen auf dem Tisch. It is a sentence that has all the three cases. So, the books, we said before, are the actors. Für is a preposition that needs, in this case, the accusative for the lesson. So we say für wen oder was, for who or what, for the lesson. So den Unterricht is accusative and the preposition auf needs dative on the table. So the indications that are also helping besides the question words are the prepositions and also the ending of the articles that changes. So in one way, we can be thankful that the articles change a little bit. So we can see if something is accusative or dative. In the last example, der Fußballspieler trifft das Tor nicht mehr. The football player does not hit the goal anymore. Of course, the who part, the subject, the topic, the nominative is der Fußballspieler. He's the person doing a thing, or not in this case. And just so we know, das Tor is accusative. Wen oder was trifft der Fußballspieler nicht mehr? Whom or what does the player not hit the goal? So this is accusative. I hope this was a little bit helpful. Don't give up. Leave comments if you want. I will try to answer them. Or you can like, subscribe. We will continue with our A1 grammar. And you will see it will get easier every week when you keep watching. I see you very soon. Thanks. Bye.